The beauty of the six thinking hats is that instead of jumping to the first solution that comes to mind, it forces you to look at a problem from many different angles. But I'm not really a hat man, so... Blue is like the conductor of an orchestra, defining your goals and the types of thinking you need to solve the problem. White is for information, gathering your facts, it's for pure data. Green is for ideas and letting your imagination go wild. It's about putting your inner critic on hold. Red signifies feelings and emotions, using your gut instinct or intuition. Yellow is for optimism. What are the benefits and what's the potential? Black is the flip side, spotting the risks, dangers, and where things might go wrong. It's the black thinking that most of us are a bit too expert at.
Okay, I want to generate some ideas. Ideas on how.
So by ensuring you view any problem from multiple perspectives, you radically increase your chances of finding an original solution.
So we're going to try and get the global stats.
Do you want some global
Susan stats? Wants me to practice applying it to a wide range of issues. And I'm already using it to structure my ideas for my upcoming art challenge.
For bullies, maybe an idea would be to visualize the words.
But before I can pull that off, I better get a move on with my training.
Things I've been tasked to do is try ordinary everyday activities in a different way. You may find it surprising to know that one of the best brain training activities you can do is brushing your teeth with your weaker hand.
Oh, this is not good. Whoa!
Science shows that you can force new connections in your brain just by having new experiences. And that can make you up to 15% more creative.
That looks like a brain. That brain was quite good.
Dried fish snack. All in the name of creativity. So has the pain been worth the gain? There's only one way to find out. I'm off to meet David Cropley at my gym for the brain for another exercise in humiliation.
So what we'd like to do today is retest you to see what sort of impact that training has had. And we're going to start with a shapes test to generate as many ideas as you can using these different shapes.
TV. That's my house. That's Jesse. Coaster.
That's your timer. I'd like you to come up with as many alternative uses as you can for that plastic cup.
It could be used for catching bugs. It could be used as a drum. Use it as a sound device.
Okay, what if gravity was half as strong as it is now?
I would be able to run a lot faster because it would be less pulling me to the ground. The moon would be further away from us.
I have no idea if I'm doing well or just looking like a lunatic. But one thing I do remember is half my score will be for fluency, or number of ideas, and the other half for originality.
People working in tall buildings might get a bit more nausea, motion sickness.
Remember this one? The torrents are incomplete drawing test. Look out.
Okay. Time's up, Todd.
Okay, so the whole thing exists within an old school television with the antennas and the buttons, but it's called the morning after show. They come out in the morning after a big night and the sun is so hot, which of course results in a bad reaction.
Okay, and what's this over here, Todd?
Oh, that's the director's cut.
I'm a bit skeptical that my divergent thinking scores might have actually improved. All right, David, I know I can rely on you to give it to me straight.
Now, for the overall, combining those tests together, there's 37 out of 50 for fluency, 36.5 out of 50 for originality, and so that was a total score of 73.5 out of 100. And that's a really excellent score.
My old scores were good, but it was originality that let me down. But this time, both my fluency and originality scores have improved. Not bad for 1 month of training for just an hour a day. So what we want to do, but there's still the innovation test left to do.
So Todd, your task is once again to do a mousetrap powered wheeled vehicle.
Oh, my old friend.
There's your old friend. You're
gonna have... And by friend, I of course mean arch nemesis. Okay, mousetrap, game on. Better make it good this time, Samson. None of that 5 out of 25 rubbish again.
That's it. Look at that. Success.
Kind of.
Yeah, I know what you're thinking. Oh, mousetrap, Todd? But just bear with me on this one.
So, I need to put the car on top, and then as the balloon expands, the car lets go. That's pretty cool if that actually works.
Yeah. Watching Todd do the mousetrap exercise, it's clear that he's thinking in a novel sense, taking risks and doing things differently from the obvious. So he recognized that the energy stored in the mousetrap is not just in the spring, but it's also embodied in the chemical structure of the mousetrap. And that's a big shift in thinking. That's a big creative step.
Okay, let's test the theory. Here it goes. Oh, yes!
Well done. It worked.
Yeah, we have fire and we have car. God. Wow, okay. Now what do we do? This thing doesn't go out. Huh? That was awesome.
Okay, Todd, look, that's really great. And, you know, I think we've seen some real creativity here today, and you've really put into practice the things we talked about. In terms of effectiveness, you certainly did a good job. I gave you a score of 20 this time in comparison to 18 last time. That's out of 25. Okay, now for novelty, last time you only used the energy stored in the spring, and this time you actually used a combination of several different things, which is something that really impressed me. So 20 out of 25 for novelty.
Much better than the 5.
Yep, absolutely.
I'm still recovering from the 5.